Good morning, class 7. Today I am starting chapter 13, exponents and powers. So before starting this chapter, we shall understand what is the meaning of these two terms, exponents and power. For that, suppose I am writing here 2 5 times, 2 into 2, 4 times and 5 times. So this number 2 is written 5 times. Now, in short, if I want to write this number, then I can write here 2 and then 5 in the power. Okay, so meaning of this chapter is that if we have long multiplication, then in short we can write this way also, 2 to the power 5, as 5 is coming, 2 is coming 5 times. Now from 2 to the power 5, 2 is known as base. And then this 5 is called exponent. Exponent. And this whole expression 2 to the power 5 is called power. So what I told you, if we have long multiplication of the same number or the different number, so we can write this number. Here I am taking example, 2 is multiplied 5 times itself. So we can write in short 2 raised to the power 5. Here 2 is called base, this 5 is called exponent, and the whole expression is called power. Okay, and it is read, already told you, 2 raised to the power 5. Now furthermore, I am taking exercise. In exercise 13.1, first question is find the value of. So we have in first part 2 to the power 6. So how will you find out the value of 2 to the power 6? You can write this 2 to the power 6. That means multiplication of 2 6 times. Now multiply them. 2 to the 4, 2 to the 8, 2 to the 16, 2 to the 32, 2 to the 64. So 64 is the value of the given expression. So same questions will be second, third and fourth also. Now I am taking question number 2. In question number 2, express the following in exponential form. So this form is the exponential form. So given expression we are going to convert in the exponential form. So in first part, we are seeing 6 is written 4 times. Right? Now, when it is written 4 times, we can write in short 6 to the power 4, or read it 6 raised to the power 4. So this is the exponential form of this expression. I am taking here 4th part also. So in 4th part we have seen 5 is multiplied 2 times and 7 is multiplied 3 times. According to that, till here write 5 to the power 2 into 7 is multiplied 3 times, so write here 7 to the power 3. So 5 to the power 7 into 7 to the power 3 is the exponential form for the given expression. Now question number 3. In question number 3, express each of the following numbers using exponential notation. So in third question we have number in first part 512. For the the numbers given in 100 and 1000, for such kind of number we have to find out here prime factorization. So here I am factorizing this number 512, dividing by 2, again by 2, again by 2, again by 2. By the divisible test, I am finding the last digit and based on that I am dividing by 2. Again by 2, 8 times, by 2, 4 times, by 2, 2 times, and last is also by 2, 1 time. So how many times we are seeing 2 here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So write at the place of 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But the question is for to write this number in exponential form using exponential notation. So
So write here 2 raised to the power 9. So this way you can write all the numbers in the exponential notation. Now question number 4. Identify the greater number wherever possible to each of the following numbers using the exponential notation. Okay, exponential notation is given to us in the question and you will find out which one is greater. So fourth question, first part, we have 4 to the power 3 or 3 to the power 4 or 3 to the power 4. Now to find out which one is greater, we have to find out multiplication. So for 4 to the power 3, we have to multiply 4 3 times. So 4 4 is 16, 16 4 is 64. Now for 3 to the power 4, write 3 in multiplication 4 times. Multiply 3 is a 9, 9 is a 27, 27 is a 81. So here we are seeing 81 is greater than 264 and 81 is a number for notation 3 to the power 4, so write here, and 64 is for 4 to the power 3 and put this sign. So we can see here 3 to the power 4 is greater than 4 to the power 3. This one is the result answer. This way you complete all the questions from question number 4. Now question number 5. Question number 5 is express each of the following as product of powers of their prime factor. So this question is same as we did in question number 3. So try to do this question. Question 5 by yourself. I am taking now question number 6. Question number 6 is simplify. 2 into 10 to the power 3. Okay. So write your question 2 into 10 to the power 3. We have to simplify, means to say we have to find out the value for this expression. Now what we do? Write 2 1 times and 10 is written here 3 times. So write here 10 into 10 into 10. Now in the next step, keep 2 as it is. Multiplication of 10 into 10 into 10, that is 1000. Now 1000 to the is 2000. So 2000 is the value for this given expression. And now fifth part. This one was the first part. Take the fifth part. In fifth part we are seeing 0 into 10 to the power 2. Okay. In the next step, write 0 once, 10 write 2 times in multiplication. Now the next step, 0 into 100. Now the last step, 0 multiplied with any number gives result 0. So 0 is the answer. Now question number 7. Question number 7 is simplify. So here I am taking first part, minus 4 to the power 3. To simplify this term, what I do now? First of all, minus 4 write 3 times. Minus 4 into minus 4 into minus 4. Now, minus minus plus, plus minus minus. So answer will be minus. Now multiply 4 3 times, 4 4 is 16, 16 4 is 64. So minus 64 is the answer. I am telling you one more way to do this question. Minus 4 to the power 3. Understand? When minus comes in the bracket and power is in odd number, then it will give us minus sign. So directly you can write here minus sign. Now 4 to the power 3. For 4 to the power 3, you have to multiply 4 3 times. So 4 4 is 16, 16 4 is 64. You can write here directly minus 64. So you can use any way to solve this question. Now children, remaining questions you will try. If you have any doubt, then definitely you will ask to me. Okay, thank you.